Here's a great question. From your perspective, is racism in America systemic? And if so,
no.
Okay. Next question.
The category, the category. Before you even go past that, the category of systemic racism is a category of CRT. Systemic racism, the concept of systemic racism is based on the assumptions of the Marxist oppressor-oppressed categories. It's based on the assumptions of the establishment of hegemonic power, and it's based on the assumptions of equity versus equality, okay? So categorically, I reject systemic racism. Categorically, okay? Even if you want to talk about it from the standpoint of right, systemic, institutional, whatever, even if you want to look at that from a historic perspective, and you can say that, you know, there used to be laws, and we knew what those laws were, right? That's why you get the Civil Rights Act, the Voting Rights Act. By the way, that's why you get the 13th Amendment, the 14th Amendment, right? We got those because we recognized that there were these structures and these laws, right? But the people who are arguing for systemic racism today, they're not pointing to laws. They're not saying, hey, there's a law that prohibits black people from ... because there are none. They don't exist. So when people say that today, what they mean is there are inequities, and the way you explain inequity is racism.
At the group level.
At the group level.
Right.
And that's CRT.
Yeah. And that's not to say that individuals may experience unfair treatment.
Absolutely.
Right?
Absolutely.
But it's all swept up into group.
Yes.
Dynamic.
Yes.
Yeah.
And the other thing that it does, too, is it says that I can't be a racist. Some of the staunchest racists I know are members of my family. I grew up, like, not liking white folks, you know? Not trusting, not liking, not... I mean, I had racist attitudes. When I was a senior in college. I was a student at Rice University, and my senior year, I transferred, which, don't do that. First of all, don't transfer from here, right? But secondly, don't transfer if you're a senior. That was I was playing football there. I started preaching when I was a junior, and I was getting a lot of opportunities to go and speak at different places, mainly because I was a football player and people knew my name, right? But having grown up in a Buddhist family, never heard the gospel till my first year in college, I was just convicted that I didn't know enough. So I transferred my senior year and I went to Houston Baptist University. And it was crazy. I went from a guy who's, you know, contemplating a career in the NFL to being a guy who's now at a university where I don't even have a scholarship anymore. And I had to figure out how to pay for school. I'd gotten married. We had our first baby 10 months after we got married because we were efficient. And so now here I am. I'm a senior. I've got a wife. I've got a daughter. And I've got to pay for school. It was crazy. And so as a ministry student, I could get half off my tuition if I was a member of a Southern Baptist church. That's how I became a Southern Baptist. But when they told me that, I asked them, not where is a Southern Baptist church? I asked where a black Southern Baptist church was. Because I was a racist. And I only wanted a church that was a black church. By the way, nobody flinched at that. But if a white student in my same situation had said, where's a white Southern Baptist church, they probably would have been brought in for disciplinary action. But not for me. I didn't want to go to church with white people, and that was not considered racist. So there's so many problems, even just with the way we categorize this. But I'm sorry, I stopped you with that question. Systemic racism.
No, that's your answering.
Okay, all right, yeah.
Yeah, because the...
No.
No, all right, good.